The man in our top of the bill tonight has also been a shot in the arm for British boxing. Adam Smith on Ricky Hatton, a star in the making.
In front of a packed Manchester crowd, American Freddie Pendleton became Ricky Hatton's first big test. But the former world champion was clinically dispatched.
Counted out, knocked out, Hatton throws the gum shield out of the ring in celebration. It was a spectacular performance. Take that, America, he says.
Even outside the ring, he's become an all-round star. Time for autograph hunters, always willing to help young fighters like James Bowers, the seriously ill youngster who's Hatton's real hero. And here's Ricky's real kid. 11-month-old Campbell is now pride of place in the tight-knit Hatton household. Ricky has helped younger brother Matthew's professional start, even working the corner, while proving himself a mature voice on all aspects of the game. As comfortable with the media as the crowds who he addressed before fighting American John Bailey just after September the 11th.
Please be upstanding for a minute silence in respect of the thousand who lost their lives in New York, please.
You always seem to say the right things, Ricky.
But it's something that, you know, it's not, you know, when I get interviewed and people talk to me, it's not that I've got it all planned or written down on script, you know, just say it the way it is.
The hitman even hit Las Vegas to be ringside for the light welterweight unification battle between Zab Judah and Kostya Tsiu. The fight was sensational, Tsiu stopping Judah in two rounds to become world king. But to stay on course for this Australian star, Hatton must deal with another Australian team, Justin Rowsell, who's trained by legend Jeff Fenwick. With the American television cameras here, Hatton has trained ferociously to make a statement.
I want to send Justin Rowsell back to Australia, and his trainer, you know, Jeff Fenwick, you know, he's one of the main men in Australian boxing terms, you know, send him back with a warning that there's a little pale Mancunian back in England that you should really keep your eye on, you know, mainly, you know, for Kostya Tsiu.
Jim, any doubts for you that he might overlook Rowsell tonight because there are bigger names out there?
No, he's far too professional in his complete outlook to the game. He's so strong in every aspect of the game because he works at every aspect of the game. He doesn't cut corners, and I'm sure he won't have cut any corners whatsoever tonight. I feel it'll take a real special fighter to beat this young man. I don't think Rowsell is special. I think he's good enough to give him a tough test.
21 stoppage wins for Ricky Hatton in 26 victories to date. Unbeaten along the way, Barry. And his power punching, especially to the body, has recalled comparisons with one Barry McGuigan.
Well, he's a wonderful man in and outside the ring. He does everything right. He's a very real professional, but his real specialty is his body punching. He's probably one of the finest body punchers, not just in the UK, in the world. He puts a lot of emphasis on it, which I used to do in my career, and it pays off. That's a sort of, you can see that long left hook where he reaches around the elbow. We'll see another example of it here. And it's just, he finds that little sweet spot every single time, the floating rib. And look where he's looking all the time. He gives him up the middle to get his elbow across and reaches around the side, bang. And it just creates a tremendous paralysis of the lungs.
Barry, the higher he goes in world echelons, are the men more able to protect against what Hatton has got?
They're more able to protect it, but if you look at this fight against Pendleton had already been shell-shocked at that stage, and he didn't know where the punches were coming from. He'd been hit so often in the body and head, he just didn't know where the next shot was coming from. And, you know, Hatton done exactly the same to this guy, and this guy's been in with the best in the world. But look at the way he ripped him open here with this shot. Now, he's an old guy, and he's in the twilight of his career, Pendleton, but, you know, he's a tough cookie, very experienced, and he just could not handle these body shots.
All in all, Rowsell is up against it here tonight, but he does have one secret weapon. His trainer, arguably the finest Australian professional in decades. Backstage now, let's meet him.
Well, Jeff, you were a great boxer, now you're a great trainer. You're working with a good fighter in Justin Rowsell. How's he going to do tonight?
Yeah, well, they've obviously brought us over here thinking that we're going to be easy and meet, but we're going to shock a lot of people tonight. Justin's really ready for this. We've put on about 6 or 7 kilos since the weigh-in, so nice and strong, and I'm very, very confident that we can go out there and upset and shock this English crowd.
Have you worked on the fact that Hatton is such a good body puncher and he's so aggressive?
Yeah, well, we've got a plan. If Justin can get in there close enough, he'll nullify the body power. And if he's in there and he ties him up at the right time, we'll nullify all that. And, you know, listen, I can tell Justin what to do, but he's got to go out there and do the job, and I'm very confident he can do that.
He's a tough Australian?
definitely is a tough cowboy.
Thank you very much.
And from Ed Robinson to Adam Smith at ringside, Spencer and Nicky with their verdict on the big one.
So, fifth fight of the year for Ricky Hatton. Can't afford any mistakes now. What do we make of this Justin Rowsell? Box of tricks, or is he going to come to fight?
I think he will be. Australians are always fit, and we know he's been a very good amateur. So he'll have a lot of experience. He's coming to win. And if he sticks behind his jab and can move a bit and is, you know, is as strong as they say, then he might have a chance. It's going to be a good test for Ricky Hatton.
Spencer, Jeff Fenwick wouldn't bring over somebody just to lie down, but Ricky is in the form of his life and should be a class above.
He's had a tremendous year, and I think this will just top it off. But this could be a tricky night with him. If Rowsell boxes on the outside, he could make it very difficult. If he decides to stand there and trade, then I think Hatton would take him apart. But I feel that Ricky's going to do a good job tonight.
Thanks very much, guys. It'll be interesting.
And one last opportunity for you to give us your verdict on the big one. It's your round. Call us, please, now on 09-009-100-199. Lines are about to close. 09-009-100-199. Hatton or Rowsell, in which round could we even have a draw? And signed portrait posters of Ricky Hatton for the winners tonight. Ricky Hatton, a winner here against John Thaxton, a winner here against Tony Pep. What can Justin Rowsell do to derail the exciting Hatton steamroll to the top? We have three live matches for you on Sunday. 1:30, this week's pay-per-view match from the Premiership. Leeds United against Leicester. The number to call, 08705-160-160. 08705-160-160. And then from 3 o'clock, Super Sunday, Sky Sports 1, interactive on Sky Sports Extra. It's Chelsea against Liverpool, live from Stamford Bridge. And that is followed at 6:30 on Sky Sports 1 by La Liga action from Spain. It's Malaga against Deportivo La Coruña. Now, if you are watching on Sky Digital tonight, you can access the Sky Active menu at any time simply by pressing the red button on your remote control. It's the Wembley Conference Centre for Ricky Hatton, the face of the future for British boxing, or so we hope. MC tonight is Michael Pass.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. Would you please welcome firstly to the ring, the challenger from New South Wales in Australia, Justin Rowsell.
Justin Rowsell, who calls himself the cowboy. He used to ride in rodeos, Glenn, and he might be in for quite a wild ride here, I think.
Well, I think he might. He's going to have to be at his very, very best. I think he will rise to the occasion. He has to. For what is this, his toughest fight? But you know, he's experienced, he's been a very good amateur. You know, he's got a lot of fights, and you know, hopefully Hatton will bring the best out of him, but he's gonna have to be his very best to stand a chance with Ricky Hatton.
Well, he really was a good amateur. Bronze at the World Championships in his home city of Sydney in 1991, and he beat the excellent Bulgarian Tonto Zontev on the way. That is good form. He went to the Olympics as well. He's only lost one out of 34 fights as a pro, and that was against the world-ranked lightweight called Lovermore Endu, and it was 3 years ago. He can box, they say, in two styles, either cagey and difficult to get at, or stand and have a tear-up with you. I think tonight he's going to try and box.
Well, I think that would be the sensible thing to do. Try and keep out of the way, use good defensive skills, try and pick Hatton up, try and get in the fight and take Hatton into the later round. What he doesn't have to do is stand, have a tear-up, because that would just turn right into Ricky Hatton's hands.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to London, England, the champion, Ricky the Hitman Hatton.
A sign that the British boxing public is slowly waking up to Ricky Hatton. Tonight the Wembley Conference Centre is sold out, and that very, very rarely happens. Well, it's a big entrance, and it's been served up here as a little hors d'oeuvre. I wonder what Rowsell is thinking. He can look at this on the big screen. I think he knows what Hatton's about, but he's looked, hasn't he, Hatton, as if he's one of the most dangerous unarmed men in the country.
He really has.
Hatton prepares to make his entrance through the smoke here. The Manchester City theme tune that he always comes into, Blue Moon. He says, you can think up any ring entrance you want for me, but once I hear that music, I feel okay.
He's a big Man City fan. He really does love that team. And I think this is the sort of thing that motivates him. He's a very different young man.
But he's going to watch City tomorrow, but there's much more important business for him tonight. You're somewhere in a hotel, probably. The City players will be watching this. They all know him well. He's big mates with Kevin Keegan. And tonight, despite going out as well in the United States on a delayed showing in 5 hours' time. Time, so that would be more or less
mid-time
viewing in the States.
Well, and that's a great thing for Ricky Hatton. The fact is that the American public get a chance to see him, and I think they'll really like him. He's got an American-type style, very aggressive, good skills. He's like a young Roberto Duran. He really is very, very good. And I think that the American public, when they see him, you know, they really take to him.
So Ricky Hatton against Justin Rowsell, Hatton's fourth defence of his WBU Light Welterweight Championship. The tail of the tape for tonight's confrontation. Hatton is 23, Rowsell's 29. The Australian is taller and has a reach advantage. If he can make it count for him, he's got to keep Hatton away from him. Both half a pound inside the 10-stone limit. Rowsell's been a professional for 5 years longer. He's only had 8 more fights, mind you, and he has boxed 19 more rounds. The reason for that is that Hatton keeps blowing away people early, mind you. 80% knockout percentage so far for the Manchester fighter, with a huge army of support here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening and welcome to the legendary Wembley Conference Centre here in this historical city of London, England. Tonight, Frank Warren Sports Network, in association with our main sponsor, Red Square, the championship drink, proudly present 12 3-minute rounds for the WBU Light Welterweight Championship of the World. We'd like to welcome our viewers watching live and exclusively on Sky Sports and Showbox, the new generation. Our officials have been appointed by the World Boxing Union in association with the British Boxing Board of Control. WBU President at ringside is Mr. John Robinson, Commissioner Charlie Robinson. Our British Boxing Board of Control representative is Mr. Simon Block. Timekeeper at the bell is Mr. Peter McCann from Harrow. We have 3 scoring judges at ringside who are all from England. Carl Rogers, Reg Thompson, and Tony Walker. And when the action commences, our referee tonight, taking part in his 96th World Championship contest, is one of the world's elite, Mr. Mickey Van from Leeds, England. Ladies and gentlemen, this is World Championship Boxing. Introducing to you, firstly, boxing out of the red corner, he's wearing the red colored trunks with the black trim. At the weighing, he scaled 110 stone, 13 and 1/2 pounds. He has an awesome record. 34 contests, 34 wins. Sorry, 31 wins. 24 of those wins coming by way of knockout, with only the one solitary defeat and two draws. He is the challenger this evening, hailing from New South Wales in Australia. Please welcome to Wembley, Justin the Cowboy Rowsell. And his opponent, boxing out of the blue corner. He's wearing the black, white, and blue colored shorts. At the weight he scaled, 139 1/2 pounds, or 9 stone 13 1/2 pounds. He's undefeated in 26 professional contests, 26 wins, 21 of those wins coming by way of knockout. He is the former undefeated light welterweight champion of Great Britain. Tonight, he takes part in his fourth defense of his championship. He is the WBU light welterweight champion of the world from Manchester, England, Ricky the Hitman Hatton. Our referee, Mr. Mickey Van, will now give his final instructions to both boxers. This is 12 3-minute rounds for the WBU light welterweight championship of the world.
Okay, fellas, you've both had your instructions in the dressing room. Just remember what I told you, no mortgage with you. Check hands, buddy corners.
The other good thing for Hatton is his problem with cuts earlier in his career hasn't recurred in the last three fights. Though I noticed that Rowsell has got quite a growth of beard there, which might be a problem in clinches, Glenn.
Well, it could be. I mean, I think one of the problems really is clashes of heads. And they said this guy is a little bit tricky, a little bit unorthodox, so whether that has a bearing on the fight, we'll have to see.
Fifth fight of the year for Hatton. He's won the other four by stoppage, and it's taken him a total of 15 rounds to do it with his body punching. Rowsell, been around a bit, caught by the left hook and looking a little bit open to it too, dropped the gloves as it landed. Watched many, many videos of this man in action. It was due to fight him in October. Rowsell wanting to hold on. But how much has he got left? He's only had one fight in the last year, this Australian, which is a little bit worrying, isn't it?
Yes, he has had a lot of inactivity, and really you want to be fighting often to go into a fight with Ricky Hatton. You've got to be busy and you've got to be well prepared.
Starting to get a reputation, but with that comes a kind of pressure to perform. He's already getting in with some hurtful shots to the body. There is that left hook that's finished off a few opponents already. He's going for it. It's that same shot, digging the feet into the canvas, getting loads of leverage, and Rowsell under heavy pressure in round one. Two uppercuts and a left hook. Not much back from the Aussie so far. Is he a busted plug? He's not going to be able to take too much more of this. Hatton here has him fried on these ropes. Nothing coming back, right uppercut. Rowsell is not throwing anything back. Mickey Van is looking very closely, the referee. Hatton threatening to do this inside a round.
Hatton do everything he wants to do with Rowsell in there. Uppercuts, body punching, really is just going to town.
Another left hook to the body. Rowsell does try to throw back. But this is proving to be a very long 3 minutes, and there's still 50 seconds left of it. With this beleaguered Aussie. Oh, lovely little right cross, two of them. An absolute pummeling, hammering, and Hatton's handing out. It's not so much who Hatton's beaten in his career so far, it's the way he's done it, like this.
Well, he's giving himself room, he's stepping round, he's getting the gap.
He's knocked him out of the ring. Rowsell has to hold onto a rope to try to clamber back. And he didn't quite tumble out onto our television monitors, but nearly. And it's a wonder that he was only down once in that round. How did he get through? He's in a bad way, then.
Yes, he is in a bad way. They're just waiting for the stool there, giving him a bit of support. But he got hit with everything there. He couldn't get out of the way. He hasn't got the speed or the movement to get out of the way. So really, he's right there for Hatton to get to. And when Hatton's got an opponent on the ropes like this, really, that's where Hatton is at his best. He's just really working the Australian over and then hits him and he falls out the ring.
Well, he hadn't had a first round win for 3 years, Ricky Hatton, but I thought it was going to happen then.
Well, it almost did. I think if he just had a little bit more time, he'd have gotten him.
A lot of refs might have stopped it, I think.
Well, I think he gave him the benefit of the doubt in a big fight. And then luckily the bell went.
He landed 42 punches. Rowsell did land 10. Don't ask me what they were.
Yeah, he managed to get a few little flurries in while he had his back on the ropes, but nothing cleanly really landed.
Here's the second round. Hatton is so thorough and professional in his approach to everything. He's super dedicated. And there's the left hook again. He does look increasingly like a fighter who's ready to go in at the very top right now. Massive left hook. The towel's come in from the Australian's corner. Nicky Van, the referee, hasn't seen it though. Nicky Van hasn't seen that towel. And Fennec takes four. Angry action at ringside to the referee. Jeff Fennec is saying to the ref, look, I've thrown in the towel. Eventually, Nicky Van steps in, and Ricky Hatton, well, he might look like a choir boy, but put him in a ring, he turns into an absolute monster.
Yes, he does. More of the baby face than the hitman. But he is a tremendous fighter. What you like about him is the way he goes to get his opponent out there. He doesn't give them a moment. He doesn't think about boxing, having a few rounds. He goes in there to get him out.
There's his mum, Carol. Dad's here as well. And this big sellout crowd salute Hatton, gives himself his own Christmas present 10 days early. Have to say about Rowsell, Hatton's way ahead of his league already, isn't he, really?
Yeah, way ahead. I mean, I think, you know, the quicker you can get Hatton in with the big names, the better, because I think he's ready for that. He thrives on that sort of thing.
Now, let's have a look at this again. The towel is thrown in by Rowsell's corner, but Mickey Van, I think it was his fault, really. He was sort of facing the other way. Didn't see that. You saw the towel flutter through. It was behind Mickey Van.
That's right, it went behind him. I mean, Mickey Van is a good referee. He was right on top of the situation anyhow. You know, so it was just a matter of time before he saw the opportunity to get in there. So it didn't make that much difference. But it was obviously the corner knew that their man was not up to this sort of task and they wanted to get him out.
And then Mickey Van did step in himself. And I don't think he'd still seen that towel there. That's enough, he says. All over round two. And Hatton takes it to 27 fights, 27 wins. 22 inside schedule, 18 of those wins inside four rounds. That's what it means to him. And now he can relax a bit. He's due to fight again, I hear, in February. Then Eamon McGee, the Commonwealth champion in April. There's his mate James Bowers, who's been seriously ill. And Ricky Hatton says that he is my hero. Puts everything in life into context. Befriended Ricky in the gym, look at that. You see, nice guys do finish first, don't they?
Yeah, they do, and it's wonderful to see. You know, making a young man very, very happy there. And I think, you know, Ricky gets a lot of happiness out of having him around.
And James has become a bit of a star himself, I hear, through his TV appearances, which is wonderful.
His dancing's getting no better, but it's...
That's brilliant.
He's a lovely kid.
Let's hear it officially anyway. Here he comes.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 36 seconds of round number two, our referee, Mr. Mickey Van, has stopped the contest. In his opinion, Rowsell being unable to continue, your winner, and still the WBU light welterweight champion of the world from Manchester, England, Ricky the Hitman Hatton.
Well, it was an absolute pasting by Hatton. No other word for it.
And I'm sure he's going to be leading around. Please, for a great game and great challenger, Justin Rowsell.
Now, I'll tell you what I'd like to see happen with Hatton now. I know he's anxious now to get to the world number one Costa Sue. And incidentally, Rowsell was Sue's sparring partner regularly for 4 years, which may not have done him too much good. I'd like to see Ricky now fight somebody like a Jesse James Leha, former world champion, but a big name still. Ben Tackey, the dangerous Ghanaian. Maybe DeMarcus Corley, who holds the WBO championship, which means a whole lot more than this WBU one. Somebody like that, Mickey Ward maybe, who was in that great fight with Shane Eary.
Yep.
Something like that, Cliff.
Yeah, I think we need it this evening with a name that the public recognises. You know, somebody that's been around, just that little step up from the opponents that he's got at the minute. And you know, just before he gets to the Costa Sousa, the big name, just give him that little platform and let him hit one of the guys that you mentioned, somebody like that, to get him right.
I think one problem he might have is that Costa Sue is going to see videos of this while he's in America. And unless Hatton gets to be number one contender for him, is he going to want him? Probably not. Anyway, we'll find out a lot more now as Ricky and Frank Warren, I think, is in there as well. And Billy Graham, the trainer, there with Adam Smith.
Well, Ricky Hatton, 27-0, your fifth win of the year. It was quite simply breathtaking. How do you do it?
Yeah, I was delighted with the win, you know. I don't think this was a tougher fight than what most people would have thought, you know. Just in boxing, Olympic Games, World Championship and Commonwealth Games, and his record was fantastic as a pro. So everyone was, you know, saying that I was the favourite, probably rightly so, but this was an harder test on paper than it, you know.
He couldn't deal with your angles, your velocity of punches, your power, and maybe it should have been stopped at the end of the first.
Maybe. I particularly, you know, I wasn't very happy with my performance. I think the worst thing happened, I hurt him too quick and I tend to smother my work. I got a little bit too close, you know. When you hurt someone that quickly in the fight, it was a bit of a rush of blood to the head and I smothered a bit of my work. But that's the way I am. I'm always nitpicking, I'm always moaning. So, but, you know, we move on, you know.
I don't think there's much to moan about. Let's bring Frank Warren straight in right now. When are we going to get Ricky Hatton against a world-class fighter? Let's say a Mickey Ward, a Ben Tackey, a DeMarcus Corley. What's next?
We'll do those fights next year. That's what we're looking to do. Ricky's going to fight again in February. And then we'll be looking towards... I'm looking to try and make the Costa Zoo fight if we can sometime in September. That's what we'd like to do.
Can you make that and when, Frank?
I just said in September we're trying to make it and why can't we make it? Of course we can do it. It's just that Ricky has got to keep busy. Sue said he's not going to fight for a while. I understand he's going to fight in Australia. So the fight can't be made early anyway. So we're talking about September for that fight.
Does he need more of a test before that with one of the fighters I've just been talking about, a top American?
Well, DeMarcus Corley has got to defend his title against Julio from Colombia. That's a mandatory defence, so he's out for a while. Maybe we'll look at a Ben Tackey fight. But, you know, we'll make the matches, and we'll make the right matches the way we're doing. And then when you apply and take your matchmaker's licence out, you can do some for us.
Well, Ricky, you tell me when you want Costa Sue, the world champion, the unified king of the light welterweights.
Well, as a fighter, that's what I am, you know. I'm a fighter, you know. I like to fight regularly, and I'll take on all comers, you know. I'd fight him tomorrow if I had the choice. Well, I've got a fantastic team behind me, you know. Frank Warren, one of the best promoters in the world. Billy Graham, as far as I'm concerned, the best trainer in the world, you know. It's an all a team effort, and I'm the baby of the team. So, you know, the minute they give me the nod, you believe me, Frank, the minute you give me the nod, them belts are coming back to England, I'm telling you.
2001, a great year. 2002, the year that makes Ricky Hatton.
I think so, yeah. I'd like to thank all my supporters for coming down from Manchester. I know it was very difficult for you guys and girls, you know, this near Christmas. And I'd like to thank the Wembley supporters. It's been a pleasure coming to the Capital performing again. And to all boxing fans, oh, you have a very happy Christmas and I'll see you next year.
Well, we look forward to it, Ricky. We can't wait.
That was the face of the future for British boxing. Tonight, unblemished, happy to report. Next year could be fantastic. Thoughts from Jim and Barry on our light welterweight star next. And then it'll be back to our British lightweight series eliminator, Graham Earl against Mark Winters. That's all still to come. Lots more live football for you next week. Monday night, Aston Villa against Ipswich in the Premiership. Live on Sky Sports 1, interactive on Sky Sports Extra from Villa Park, 7 o'clock Monday evening. On to Tuesday night, and at 7, we are live with Bundesliga action. Two of the top sides, Bayern Munich against Borussia Mönchengladbach. That's Tuesday night at 7 on Sky Sports 1. And also in the Premiership, live pay-per-view action for you Tuesday night. Arsenal against Newcastle, and the number to call for information on that one, 08705 160 160. Ricky Hatton's reputation will be spreading further afield after that. Australia's finest, Jeff Finnick, would surely agree. There aren't too many out there like a winner tonight. Justin Rowsell, brave but outpowered like Hatton's previous challengers over what's been a marvellous 2001. What did you think of that, Jim?
Well, I think Ricky Hatton is so good that people are going to start complaining about him, because we've watched him in his last five fights just beating people up. And if boxing is not competitive, then there's something wrong somewhere. And I think the only people who can make it competitive with young Hatton are the fighters in the top half dozen in the world. And that's not easy for Frank Warren, as he was saying, to get those guys into the ring with Hatton. So the problem now is going to be find meaningful opponents. I think what he's going to have to do, if you can't get the top 10 fighters, is to get people that we know. We've been talking about Eamon McGee, Junior Witter. These are fighters, they may not be good enough to beat Hatton, but the people in Britain want to see those fights.
I think therein lays the problem, because although I think Hatton is ready to fight Costazu right now. Right now, he's immensely strong. And if we put him in against a guy like someone like Mickey Ward or Jesse James Lea or Ben Tackey, the chances are that he could get cut. That's the one vulnerability about him. And I think he's ready to fight someone like DeMarcus Coley right now. If we can get him a shot against someone like Jesse James Lea early in the new year, he's ready for a world title fight right away.
Back to the job he's done tonight, Barry. Yeah. Nobody suggested Rowsell was up with the very best in the world, but Ricky told us afterwards he does have ability and he does have a track record.
You're damn right he has, and he's trained extensively with Costazu. And I said when I was writing about this thing today that, in fact, that's probably sort of put a sparring partner's mentality into the guy. But he's fought a lot of good guys. He's only one defeat. And he was just taking a part here. It just goes to show you the difference here with Hatton. Hatton is one of the best fighters in the world, and I'm telling you, Costazu knows that.
Ricky's other point to us, he felt he was self-critically smothering his own work, Jim. Would you expand on that?
But I mean, he was getting far too close. He's punching. It probably wasn't his best performance of recent fights, because he was too much on top of the guy, where he should have stood back maybe a little half step, given himself room to punch. It was allowing the fellow to survive. And we have to say, full marks to Rowsell, because no sign of him quitting there. He was there. And we're just saying to Barry before the fight started, people from Australia, they're macho type guys. They don't quit. They become Shannon Taylor last week showed us the same thing. But he just couldn't get into the fight. Out of his league, this little fella is just far too good for guys at this level.
Absolutely. The difference with Hatton is he's immensely strong, and it's seductive. Getting inside and being able to rip a guy apart is so attractive and it's so magnetic. He's able to do that, so he likes to get up close with guys. He's got so much strength up close. He's phenomenal.
And Barry, was there not a little more of that from Hatton tonight, implying further development between the fights this year?
I'm telling you, this guy knows he's got to get better. He knows he was caught a few times in the first round. He wanted to be really fastidious and picky. There were a few shots at the beginning where he got caught a little bit. He realised he's got to get better. But that's the sort of the macho thing about him. He knows he's got to get in close and rip these guys apart. But he's getting better with each fight.
We talked about the trappings of success going to the heads of young sportsmen. This 23-year-old doesn't look happy with himself
Absolutely.
At all tonight,
He's switched on. He knows what he's got to do. He's level-headed. He knows that he's got improvements to make. And he realises that Rowsell is not the top dog. He knows he's not a top-level fighter. But, you know, he's got to measure it bit by bit. It's all, as I say, one fight at a time.
Reminding myself, Barry, that he's only 23. Yeah. There's that look of maturity every time he comes out. He's looking stronger and stronger, more lethal.
Let's get a word at ringside with Spencer and Nicky.
Five big fights this year, five clinical knockout wins. Is he the best fighter we've had since Prince Nasir Muhammad?
I think he certainly is. He's the best fighter that we've got definitely at the moment. You know, he's been improving all the time. He's only 23 years of age, and every performance he seems to get better. The way he picks his shots, he moves off the side all the time, never stands still. And this guy, you know, he's going to go on and win bigger and better titles.
Justin Rowsell had only lost once. He didn't know what to do with Hatton. What do we do next with Ricky? Do we need a big name? I mean, Frank was talking about Costa Hugh possibly in September. What would you do, Nicky?
I think so. I think Costa Hugh is the man at the end of the line. He's the main man at the moment, a brilliant champion. There's a few others out there, you know, other champions that we can pick up along the way. I just don't think there's anybody apart from Zoo that can stop Hatton at the moment. It was painful stuff. Don't need to explain anything. People saw the slow motions. It was painful to watch. It was just the clinical stuff. Brilliant punching.
Well, maybe we'll have an undisputed light welterweight champion in 2002. Hope so.